So if you're using Zoom or any other video conferencing software,
how do you get your audio quality going from this horrible MacBook Pro built-in microphone sound
to sounding as crystal clear and as nice as this audio quality? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you how. So welcome to the video. I'm Mark Brown from Editor's Keys, and this is part of our quarantine content. We're going to give you loads of tips to help you through the lockdown period. And in this video, I'm showing you how you can use a USB microphone to get much better quality for your Teams video conferencing calls. So I'm going to run you through how you can actually change to using a USB microphone and exactly how it works. So the trick really here is to use an external USB microphone, but I know a lot of people don't realize you can actually do this, and you may already have a USB microphone at home. If you don't, I'm using the Studio Series SL600. I'll put a link in the description to also the cheaper SL150 microphone. And the reason that we love USB microphones is that they're just plug and play. You just plug them in, and then from within Zoom, you can select that as your input mic and you're good to go. So if you want to do that, if you already have a USB microphone available, all you need to do is go to Zoom here at the top, go to preferences, and then it will start off in general. But what you need to do is go down to audio, and then you can see you've got the option of your built-in microphone or your USB microphone. And then from here, you can change your input levels. You can tick it to automatically adjust microphone volume. I think if you're using a good quality USB microphone, I would have that ticked off. But that's going to make such a big, big difference to your Zoom or Skype video conferencing calls. If all of your team have one of these, and if you're using headphones, you're going to get some really, really nice clear audio, because, you know, we've all been there. You've been on a call, it starts cutting out a little bit, the internet goes bad. And if the audio goes, it's the first thing that makes you want to hang up and try again. You know, if the video's a bit glitchy, but the audio sounds good, you can all stay on the call and at least listen to what's going on. So have a look at that. Also, if you can't get a USB microphone and you are stuck, unfortunately, with your built-in microphone, just make sure you're in a room which doesn't have a lot of echo. So maybe head to a spare bedroom like I've done, because things like your mattress, your curtains, things you might have on the wall will really, really help. And you just want to avoid as much echo and reverb as you possibly can. So there we go. That was my quick tutorial to help you get better video conferencing calls on Zoom or Skype when you're stuck in this lockdown. And remember, if you want to check out any links to those things I talked about in the video, check out the links in the description below. And remember to check out the full lockdown playlist, because I'm going to be doing tutorials on how you can actually get much better video quality just using the inbuilt microphone in your MacBook Pro or your PC. There's some things you can do in your room without any external lights, without paying for anything, that can really help you get much better video quality. So if you want to see that, check the link in the description below or click up here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.